Well, guys, it's the big
200.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
We did 200 goddamn episodes of this fucking show.
Yeah, no, I was about to say we're blowing out 200 candles, but we all smoke, so that's not happening.
We can get through eight, and then we're going to all need a nap.
Yeah, we're gonna just let the cake burn.
Yeah, thank you guys for fucking continuing to listen to this madness. We get very sappy and sentimental towards the end of this episode, so we don't have to burn it up too much here. Unless
yeah,
you guys
we cover it, but yeah, we do appreciate you guys very much. And the
we do.
And,
yeah, I know.
The fact that you have a connection with us and whatever you know impact this show has in your life, big or small, it means the world to us.
Yeah, I know we gripe and grumble, kind of roll our eyes at the concept of the fans sometimes, but we really do love you guys, and we love that you give a shit about this show.
Yeah, I still don't believe you guys exist,
and you've met hundreds of them.
I know.
Yeah.
Yeah,
but
it's fucking. We had a all the Mean Boys all timer. He's got his number retired. 9/11. Ramzi Badawi in the studio. Always one of our favorite guests. Who better to ring in the special day?
Yeah.
Than him.
Yeah.
It's just a pretty straightforward Mean Boys episode. We didn't really do anything that.
Good episode.
We didn't put together a big thing.
I think it's a fun sketch commemorating.
Yeah, we got a nice sketch.
Tried to give you a good episode.
Yeah.
We talk a little bit about the legacy of our bullshit at the end.
Why navel gaze too much, you know?
Yeah, well, I don't know. We'll see you at 201.
Yeah. Good episode.
Shouldn't have done this part last. We should probably should have saved some steam for the big 200th episode. Yeah, we done. Did we already say that we did 200 of them?
Yeah.
Yeah. Fuck. Okay.
I'll plug this real quick. Listen
that's
to
one
leaving.
Less than 201. I'm just gonna do that joke for Tom right now.
Oh, listen to Leaving the Tribe, my other podcast. There's a thing that goes in the intro. Yeah.
Now,
actual thing.
How many episodes is Leaving the Tribe at?
Still under 10. I think we're at 8.
Nice. Mm. Okay. Wow. 8.
Yeah.
Wow. That's one more than 7.
Yeah. You know what? For our 9th episode, we'll get a guest that we've never had on before. Ooh. Wait. I like this show. Why am I trying?
You're on me.
I am the show.
I am the show.
Whoa. Okay.
All right.
Dom's got an ego.
Big Dick Goss fucking swinging nuts on the intro.
Well, we're recording 2 hours late because Tom wouldn't come out of his dressing room. I guess he found the green Sour Patch Kid or what the fuck ever in his little green room.
You want only brown Sour Patch Kids. We explained those don't exist.
Oh, yeah. You're thinking of the Coca-Cola gummies. Yeah. I tried to explain it to him.
He just kept screaming about sour diversity.
You just thought they were curvy Latin women that they'd invited into the Sour Patch community.
You can make anything brown if you color it.
Yep. That's the kind of comedy that warranted doing it 200 times. Let's Xerox that 200 times.
My ass, and now it's just a wall of gray.
Let's see if you even recognize it. Here's the show.
Hey, everybody. Welcome to the Mean Boys Podcast. Happy 200 episodes, and here's to 15 or 20 more. I'm Connor McSpadden.
I'm Keith Carey.
I'm Ramzi Badawi.
And I'm
Hugh Jackoff. I was a fucking...
Just keeps stabbing himself with the claws.
That might be
ow.
Well done. That may be my favorite opening. I was not expecting that.
He's got like a real Hugh Jackman look to him right now. I love that.
Well, yeah, I've been saying he looks like Wolverine, but like bad Wolverine. Yeah.
I told you, when I had shorter hair, I told you guys I look very Wolverine-ish, and you guys were like, sure.
Well, the way I've been describing your hair is it looks like you have too much hair and not enough hair.
Yeah.
Well, it looks good today, but normally you have like this thing where you're sort of sweaty, so you have like three different widow's peaks going.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, and it's like the guy they tried the experiment out on, and it didn't work, so they just left him in the street. Yeah.
your weapon W.
Yeah. Like,
yeah.
I was saying earlier, Tom has the haircut of a guy who's going to sell me spent uranium.
I give you good price.
He has bought, as I'm fond of reminding him, he has bought vape juice from a homeless guy. So, I mean, that is not the most dangerous commodity he would have dealt in.
Yeah, well, that was actually just Ramzi pushing a shopping cart. Yeah.
That was one of my minions.
I'm running a
scam on Vons. Don't worry about it.
I tried it. That was Lysol and petroleum jelly. That shit was terrifying.
You guys have no regulating body for Coinstar machines? It's international waters.
In my defense, In my defense, I was very high by myself in New York City. So yeah, what did you think was going to happen? But I was wearing a Russian coat in the summer. Of course I was going to buy.
The worst night of my life was dealing with Tom in the largest city in the world that I also did not know how to navigate.
Like, if anyone saw that transaction, they wouldn't know who was in danger.
Yeah. No,
there's no way it was. That was definitely a hand soap dispenser someone pissed in.
Yeah. I needed
one of those, like, monkey backpack leashes that, like, Santa Monica parents have.
There should be a Mean Boys one for Tom for any time you guys are on the road. Just any time you secure him with it.
Yeah, yeah. We have like an adult Bjorn.
Yeah.
Carry him around. Like, he's taller than me, but I'm still carrying him somehow.
I feel bad because you've had to deal with the worst experience babysitting me high, and you've had the worst experience babysitting me drunk.
Yeah.
And, you know, Ramsey gets to do it when I combine the two.
No, so
when you get back on heroin.
Yeah.
Every time.
Back on heroin.
I've only run into Tom at a pleasant level of high. Like, every time Tom's been high around me, he's had, like, just an assortment of gummies and things to offer. It's always been a pleasant experience.
Oh, no, when Connor had to babysit me, it started with me buying vape juice from a homeless man and ended with me covered in white sauce from a pita. It was...
Yeah, you bought a gyro from a different, slightly less homeless man.
Yeah, well, he's eating 2 a.m. street gyro, and it just fucking explodes all over him. And I look up at him like he's... Like if the SeaWorld thing was filled with tzatziki sauce was...
You there, human version of Watto. Give me Saudi Arabia's messiest sandwich.
Yeah, well, yeah,
and
remember,
he just looks at me giggling, and I'm like, oh, my God. It was like fatherhood. The whole... It was... And it's like the hardest part. It's like he is tremendously bigger and stronger than me. So it's like it all comes down to like trying to reverse engineer tricks to whatever like can still reach his what's left of his conscious mind.
Well, I'm training a Russian circus bear.
You have to use rhetoric against Tom. You can't use the force. You have to be persuasive.
You're trying to trick a computer in Blade Runner. Like that's how you get Tom to do his stuff.
I remember eating the pita, and I remember you getting more and more angry. But I was enjoying the pita too much to really care, and I'm behind you, and you're about to turn around, and right as you turn around, just like a giant dollop just falls all over my pants. You turn around, you see me, you look so exasperated, and then I laughed the gyro out of my mouth
because
I saw you react, and I did a spit take laughing because I saw how you upset you were.
Spit take chunks.
I did.
This fucking indigent Gallagher show. It was...
Is the
horrible.
Person who has a disposition like in high school? Connor was voted least likely to become a babysitter. There's nobody who has a disposition to care for people less.
Yeah. Well, it was just it was fucking impossible. Like it was like it just like I'd like walk half a block, I'd look behind me, and be like, okay, stop going through that mailbox, we're going over here.
Stop going through that.
I wanted to see if there was a whole turkey in there, like in video games.
He's just trying to read a sign with nothing on it, and it's like, come on, we'll get to it later. Later.
Oh, it's a wall.
Yeah. And we had to go all the way from Manhattan to like deep Brooklyn, and it was just, and it's like a couple trains switches, and there's closures, and my phone's dying, and I'm just, it took for fucking ever.
It's tough to get Tom on a train when he's sober, let alone high. I mean, it's very difficult.
Oh, no, it's way too easy to get Tom on a train. as we found out from our Portland live show,
where
the train was the problem.
You insisted on saving $23 on the train, which you more than I'm sure made up for in cigarettes and food on your travels, and then got stopped by a fire, and you were almost late to the show.
Yeah, two fires.
Do you guys like Portland?
It's okay.
Not really.
I fucking hated it.
I like Portland for exactly 48 hours.
Yeah.
1 second longer, and I cannot abide it.
I was there recently, and I remember walking around, and I remember every single house had, like a sign in the lawn, like, you know, like a realtor.
Yeah.
But it said, like, our America is diverse. Trans friendly, yada blah blah.
Right,
but it was just the whitest people on the planet.
Yeah, yeah. Which I appreciate the effort, I guess, but it is sort of a thing of like, we know
where are they though? Like,
yeah,
you know what I mean.
I don't like any community that likes itself.
Yeah.
You know, I don't like being in any place where they're like, fuck yeah, this is with Chicago. You know, I like every city to be like, yeah, we know. Fucking sorry, shut up. Like, I don't like the I don't like pride of any kind.
I also hate the donut thing that they have going on.
Oh, a voodoo?
Donuts are meant to be sold to you by an angry Korean man who doesn't want your business. None of this.
But this is like very much a California thing, the weird, like the angry Asian man who like will sell you a donut for a nickel.
Really? So everywhere else, I I guess that's my fault. I'm in the cave, as Plato would have said, you know?
Plato's donut hole.
As Plato would have said about you, or a lot of guys on Reddit, or me when the mics are off, or, you know, a lot of people. Would.
You know, or whatever Jordan Peterson put in chapter two, you know.
I believe you're the expert. Does he?
I am. And I don't want to make this about Jordan Peterson.
You want to make it about donuts and race.
You don't want to make it about
race and donuts.
I've not.
Saying, can the white man get a beignet?
I've never encountered anything you don't want to make about Jordan Peterson.
That's a fair point.
I believe he got a shout out in your like relationship anniversary post. You know?
I do want to point out that you're talking about how much you hate Portland while you were also literally drinking a can of Stumptown cold brew.
Well, here's
the most
thing.
Portland shit you could possibly be doing.
I don't know. I think coffee out of a can is cool because it's like it's
so does Portland.
You think so?
Stumptown is Portland.
Drinking coffee.
It even says nitro on it.
This looks like
that's a Portland-ass word.
This looks like I'm drinking coffee out of a natty ice can. It's cool.
I see your point.
You know, I don't know. It felt less European.
Looks like some sort of limited edition Bush.
You ate less European?
It felt less European.
It's got a European like vibe to letters. What is it called? Calligraphy?
That's not in any way but calligraphy.
But that's close, Tom.
Yeah.
You're in the neighborhood.
Yeah, well, calligraphy in Japan is just kanji, and they're just like, ooh, this one letter means a word, and it's, like, very fancy.
No.
I never figured out the American version of calligraphy.
Letters.
Cursive?
It's letters.
Yeah. Fonts? What do you...
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Yeah, font. Font-wise, it's got a European strewed to it.
Well...
Hang on a goddamn minute.
You knew what I meant.
No, I didn't. And neither did you.
And just when I was about to apologize for getting us here, Tom says Stroot.
What is... Hang on.
Well, Tom's like... The way you communicate is like 90% confidence.
Right? First of all, spell Stroot.
Stroud.
There you go. Okay. That's what I thought.
Yeah. Well, how did you think it was spelled?
Define it.
Huh? How did I say? Use it in my sentence.
Tom is a dumb shit.
No. How did I use it earlier?
I don't even remember.
It's got a European strewed to it.
Energy. It means energy.
Yeah, man. I got that BDS. That big dick strewed.
Use it in my sentence was the best thing. Any dude, you guys, let's call it a podcast. It's over.
Yeah, I see you at 201.
That's episode 200, guys.
Yeah. In my sentence.
I don't remember how I used it.
Man,
that's the thing. If you just put sounds together, people will get the essence of what you're trying to say.
Totally.
Strewed could also mean essence. Energy, essence.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. The general strewed.
You could have also said energy or essence. Or
General Strewed sounds like a lesser Star Wars villain.
Yeah.
General Strewed.
Oh, yeah. It took over after Thrawn.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like Jordan Peter has a very self based Strewed.
Jordan Peter is Jordan nobody.
That is not a guy.
Peterson.
Who did I say?
Jordan Peter.
Okay. Well, I'm sure it's somebody.
Yeah, he directed Get Out.
Yeah.
What's that movie called? Go Home?
Jordan
and
Peter
and the other one,
somebody.
We.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, there's always someone named something. People got fucking crazy names.
Tom, it's 4 in the afternoon. This is...
You should have been awake for so long.
I am awake. I'm making coherent points right now.
Yeah,
using three-syllable-ass words and just fucking coherent three syllables and just, you know, bringing out a very specific strut for this episode.
I finally figured out exactly what your hair looks like. 90s minor league baseball player.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely.
80s or 90s?
90s.
I was born in the 90s.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, well, then there you go. It's like, yeah. I'll figure it out.
It all adds up.
It's a great point. It's 90s?
You just said 90s, you fucking goldfish. Like, can you... How, like, what, like, you have no ability to hear and also be thinking it's on or off, you know?
Yeah, well, you know, it's this podcast is about saying words.
Hey, man, it takes a lot of Strewed to keep this engine running.
Yeah.
It's simultaneously minor league baseball from the 90s and also high school football from the 70s.
Yes.
Like, he takes off his helmet, and that's what Joe Namath looks like. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah, it's the Bulldozer.
I played football.
The Bulldozer. Did you really?
Yeah, in the 2000s.
Nice, man.
Yeah.
What position did you play?
I was a kicker for the Philadelphia Eagles. I'm amazed no one's asked.
Yeah, I played nose guard, linebacker, fullback, and center a little bit.
I just want to comment on how it's a hot summer day here in Los Angeles, and Dom is pit staining through the hoodie that he is wearing with nothing underneath it.
Am I pit staining?
Yes. Yes,
look at
you are.
Where it's wet and dark.
That's better.
Tom, back to the hair. Don't you usually shave your head for summer? This is how I usually know when it's summer.
No, I'm shaving my head for discipline reasons.
Yes, the PacPal sundial, as we call it.
Yeah, Dom shaves his head for discipline reasons, which you know is a great idea because the people that worked for Tyler Durden in Fight Club.
Yes. It worked.
Definitely, I guess.
I lost a lot of weight.
Yeah, but you didn't blow up a bank, though.
Yeah, I wasn't trying to. I wanted to, I could have.
Is this a concept that you guys have gone through a lot, that Tom shaves his head for disciplinary reasons?
He wouldn't stop shaving his head.
Did you catch yourself smoking weed?
I know. My literal Nazi stepfather used to do that to me. He would shave my head if I got in trouble.
Yeah, well, I mean,
that should be a reward in a Nazi household.
Yeah, you're your own Nazi dad.
I mean, in terms of discipline, yes.
Nazi discipline.
Yeah, not in terms of, you know, people.
Sure.
You know, I don't wish Nazi on people. I wish Nazi upon discipline upon my head,
you know,
but not.
He built a lot of hospitals, and he had a little something called stick-to-itiveness.
It was admirable.
My dog had gumption.
Yeah, I have all of none of the Nazi morals with all the Nazis strewed when it comes to self.
You're really big.
I'm gonna stick with the strewed thing. I don't know why you guys are getting so weird about it.
Tom is really playing some fourth dimensional checkers right now.
Yeah, I don't even know how to play checkers. I'm a chess man.
Well, I'm exhausted.
You know what was weird? I did a show with 103 degree fever in San Diego, and the shows went well. And then afterwards, some girl came up and was like, "My mom would have loved you." And I was like, "That's not something that I hear very often." I was like,
"I mean, my mom loved you, but that's not indicative of my mom."
Well,
was her mom Christopher Dorner?
I was going to say, incidentally, Tom's fan base is people with 103 degree fever.
she goes,
there's a very high turnover rate with Tom Goss's fan base, you know?
And I was amazed. I was like, really? Moms usually avoid me. And she's like, yeah, no, she would have loved that Hitler joke. And I was like, yeah? And she was like, yeah, she was a Nazi in Germany in World War II. I was like,
wait,
what?
Her mom?
Yeah.
How old was this lady?
Like, I think 30s or 40s. Yeah.
Check your math there.
She was in her 30s. Her mom was a
Nazi. So she would have been born in, like, 1920.
Okay.
So 1920, 30 or 40 means 25. That she would have had that kid in the 90s when she was 70.
Wait, she wouldn't have had the kid in the 90s.
80s or 90s if she's 30 or 40.
It was like late 30s or 40s.
Okay, so let's say 1978, when this 68-year-old Nazi had a kid that loved your stand-up. Now, I know they've got bases on the moon, but I don't know how good the technology is. They're making 68-year-old women have healthy, racist, I'm assuming, San Diego babies.
If you have a baby when you're 68, one of the mental symptoms is that it likes Tom's comedy.
It's true.
That with flippers and a taste for hip
and
buns.
You know what? I didn't check her facts with my math, and it turns out that
I would check it against somebody else's math if I was...
Yeah, that doesn't add up, actually.
Now that I think about it, she was a bus driver.
That doesn't add. Wait, no, 40s.
Are you sure she didn't mean grandma?
She said mom.
Okay, so this is...
But maybe she was raised by her grandma.
All right, so we got this old cum Nazi baby.
Yeah.
Who's a big fan of you.
Sometimes people are raised by their grandmas, but they call them mom. Is that a thing?
No, that's not a thing.
Not in the, let's call it the Nazi community.
Yeah, that's a weird thing.
No, that is a thing, actually. So.
People call their grandparents mom?
Yeah,
oh,
I know
sure,
a lot
yeah.
of, like, you know, it's like if mom and dad are, like, fucked off or in jail or something. It's not uncommon to just, you're raised by your grandma, you just call them mom.
Really?
Yeah, like, you know
that's crazy. I know the grandma steps in a lot. I would think that you would call them grandma. It feels weird to call them something they're not.
Yeah, well, dude, I dated a girl who fucking, so her mom had a kid.
Yeah.
Like, it was her. And then, a year in, was like, I can't raise this kid. So gave it to her sister. So then but it's still around. So now she's just calling her aunt mom and her mom aunt. It's a whole fucking...
I swear to God, Keith, your current girlfriend, Jordan, right now is the only time you've ever not dated is somebody who just has had... I can't believe she's not insane.
Oh.
All your other girlfriends are like, well, I dated this girl one time. And she was sort of into Satanism, and it was a weird...
No, that's this one. Satanism's fine. I'm
well, she wears
kidding,
it. She wears it nicely. Jordan is an incredibly well-adjusted
person.
She's into
what I would call a totally acceptable level of white girl voodoo.
Like, sure. Absolutely.
Hold on, we have Opie on the phone. He's got some thoughts about this.
No, but like, nah. For real, though.
Jesus fucking Christ.
I'm going to have to combust ghosts.
Yeah, can you move your Ouija board from the living room? Because I can't touch it for some reason.
Opie, it says Parker Brothers on it.
My magical beliefs prevent me from moving your Ouija board.
Yeah, I got a peanut allergy, but for the spooky.
By the way,
I wish he was stealing food so I could have just put pentagrams on stuff that I instead of us all stealing his food. But I wish I could have cursed all the food in the house to keep opium.
I do love that. I do love that.
Who wrote 666 on my muffin pan?
I love that Opie was like a Christian, but also had just like random weird African beliefs. It would always crack me up because he'd be like, "Yo, man, I go to church every Sunday and I never walk by daffodils." Nah, dog. My uncle taught me you walk by a daffodil. Nah, dog. His, my uncle was cursed.
It's true. His worldview is a real trail mix. Like there's some like early 2000s YouTube blog ideas.
Yeah.
There's some Christianity. There's some African stuff from Lagos. It's all in there.
Let me tell you, the year Opie's been having, sign me up. Yeah. I'll take the African beliefs. I'll take it all, baby.
Goddamn, the secret is working.
Yeah, I've only fucked with Ouija boards once. And it was homemade.
Yeah, it was there. Russ Gern.
Had a homemade Ouija board?
We made a Ouija board in a hotel room in Fresno because we were on the road for Halloween and we wanted to do something spooky.
I assume every motel in Fresno comes with a how to make a Ouija board guide of
well,
some sort.
We just wrote letters on paper and then cut a hole in a fucking like a Dixie cup.
No, in Fresno, that's what's in the drawer instead of the Bible.
Yeah, it's a Ouija board.
I did
talk to the guy who died in here last week.
Yeah, that's when I'm in Fresno in hotels, I read it. That's how I go to sleep. I read the Ouija board.
I did
A B calligraphy.
I did a Ouija board when I was a kid, and I also did it recently in here with a girl I was hooking up with. Which post Ouija board sex, weird.
That's gotta be weird.
That is a little weird.
Like,
yeah.
Oh, it says anal.
Because it was moving and I wasn't moving it, and she said she wasn't moving it. I'm sure it was just the fucking collective unconscious thing or whatever, but it was weird to be like, all right, now that we've invited the demons, let's
what are you asking?
That sounds so rad.
Get your pussy out.
Were you asking it some kind of like some sexual question?
Should I wear a condom? Oh, I'm seeing an N.
Yeah.
Oh man, that's funny. No, but did you really?
Who should be on top? I did. Yeah,
that's
like
fun,
6 months ago.
Oh, it
like
just
that.
Says me, and then you get butt fucked by a ghost.
Well, it was like the fucking letters were just moving random. It was just kind of like circling the board through the alphabet.
Right.
And she said, she's like, I looked it up, and that means a demon was trying to get out. And I'm like, that's just like, what? The 19-year-old is writing the Ouija board wiki. How are we translating this? A demon never got out to, like, fucking, create this rule.
But also here it's possible. This is a house where it could happen.
Yeah, this is the one non-Catholic chunk of this neighborhood.
This is
like,
the only home in history that's gentrified out the demons.
The demons are like, yeah, I had to go to Highland Park, man. Just get the fireworks were too much for me.
Yeah.
Do you know anybody with a two-bedroom in Boyle Heights?
Say, I bless my
get friendly preferred.
Fuck.
Looking for 1,400 or less.
How have you been, Ram Dog?
Good, man.
How has the 200 episodes of Mean Boys impacted your life?
Well,
let's
listen,
take
man.
A look back. Someone came on your face, which
somebody
I forgot about until
face.
Right now.
It was a photo of your face.
It was a photo of
don't
my face.
Steal my valor.
Yeah, yeah.
Go ahead.
Did you come on my face without me knowing?
No, I came on my face.
No. You're right. Someone
a bunch
came on
of
my
times.
Face. It's changed my life for the better. I don't know where I would be without it. Probably 300 to 400 Twitter followers less.
Yeah.
Lighter, yeah. So, great overall. I'm trimming down. Took down a couple pounds.
What are you doing? You back on the keto?
Pure keto, which is actually bringing me into my next subject. I'm doing this I'm doing energy coconut oil. Tell me what you guys do.
How dare you say you don't like Portland? After, like,
it's a coconut oil. Hear me out on this one, right? 400 milligrams of caffeine with each serving.
Wait, okay,
is
all right.
Making or a thing that exists?
It's a thing I'm thinking about getting into.
Well, yeah, and you just dump it in your coffee every
just
morning.
Dump it
you
in
know,
your coffee
it, it helps you move smoothly into the day.
Absolutely. Yeah,
a lot
yeah.
of clean, burning fats.
Be the bullet.
I did. Me and Connor were at Opie's house the other day, and there was like snacks, and I was because I'm going hard. I was fucking around for a little while, but now I'm
right.
going hard.
Okay.
So anytime now I go to like a party and there's like snacks, I'll always ask the host. I'll be like, "Do you have like just like a mouthful of olive oil I could have?" Do you have any just general maybe I don't know like a coconut I could chew on for
yeah.
a little bit?
I'm looking for exactly 9 almonds.
Have you guys ever had...
You have 8? No, I'll pass.
Preferably pecans. I mean, I want a lower net carb, but you know.
You guys ever eat garlic chips?
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
They burn.
What? Explain.
Do you think
are you a vampire?
Are
you,
little yeah. balls of garlic?
No, like garlic chips are those little... They look like little like wood chips, and then you eat them, and they're garlic.
Are you eating a clove of garlic?
No, like they're in chip form.
Okay.
And like a bag that says garlic chips or like just something that someone
in
gave
Asian
you?
In Asian restaurants with a little spoon thing in them.
I think that's chili. It's a little spoon thing in it? Yeah, that's
no,
chili
sauce. Proud. It tastes like garlic.
I don't think I've ever had that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I'll
yeah.
be on the lookout for it. Should I go to a place and find it today?
I mean, yeah, it hurts your mouth. I think it's killing the bacteria. That's why your the things burn and there's no fire a lot of times.
Whoa. Okay. All right.
Thomas, this is Scientology. Is yeah. Thomas is
when right. things burn and there's no fire, it's
usually
it's
garlic.
Probably garlic. Yeah.
That's cleansing.
It's either love or garlic.
Oh, yeah. I wish it was garlic more.
Oh, that's so funny.
Anyway, it tastes good besides the hurt.
Man, you're on a good one today, dude.
Yeah, dude. Yeah, you are. Is it ginger he's thinking of? That's what I'm like.
No, I eat ginger by the handful. It's not ginger.
That's too much ginger, my dog.
Too much ginger.
Yeah,
dude.
But my whole family goes fucking ham on the ginger.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You got to get on Ramsay's diet where somebody just hands you one fist of uncooked beef. Then you eat that while you just frown at a CrossFit gym.
Dude, it's mainly been nut oils lately. Just yeah. doing a lot of oils.
I thought you said you didn't get your face combed on.
Oh, yeah. That's a fair.
That's
no, how do you just drink it like just
spoonfuls.
Just spoonfuls.
So fuck, dude, I've like read when I was doing keto. Like,
what
I
are your shits stuff. Like?
Fairly non-existent. I have not been shitting very much lately.
See, I felt like I had like non-stop diarrhea when I was doing keto.
That sounds like peak of fit. Your body's no longer producing waste. Every single thing is being metabolized. You know what I mean? You've turned yourself into a perpetual motion machine.
I mean, it's like it's crazy. I've
if anything, I'm actually making. I grew a new finger.
You ever do the strips? The keto strips?
No.
You piss on it, tells you how far into keto you are. Mine is like dark purple, dude. I'm pretty deep in. So. My goal is to get into. I just want to. I want to lose like 25 pounds.
How much do you weigh?
It goes all the way from yellow to all the way to purple, and then Ramsey is a smoke on the water. He's just deep purple. He's way down in there.
I weigh currently like 150 pounds. I want to drop an insane amount.
Why?
Of weight.
I love.
You look good, dude. You got the veins popping and shit.
Here's what I want to do.
Originally, it was like, okay, what'll make me more bookable? Glasses. That won't work. I got to be Silver Lake skinny. Why don't you just be you, baby?
Here's what I'm gonna do. And you guys follow this. Follow everybody.
As a guy who knows Ramsey's personality pretty well, that is also not going to work. That's probably one of the worst moves.
Okay, 200 episode. I'll make the declaration here. I'm gonna lose a bunch of weight and grow a really long beard, and then my career will be off the ground.
I think this may work.
It will
you know?
Work. You guys have no. You guys all see. Declared here first. I'm going to grow a long beard and get skinny. And people are
going to
go, that guy knows stuff.
You're going to look
best...
like an old wizard.
Yeah, you're going to look like Osama. We got trapped in that cave.
You're going
to
look like pre-death Howard Hughes.
My favorite like part of like every Ramsey scheme is I'm just like enjoying it. Man, this is funny. Okay, yeah, all right, sure. And then in about 20 minutes, I go, now where is Ramsey's girlfriend in all this? You know, how does she feel about all of this that's going on?
Yeah, do men with long beards fuck?
I mean, not consensually, but...
Well, yeah, and the Greeks, there was the Greeks, and they did a lot of fucking, usually young boys, but
right.
It was still fucking.
Yeah.
So is that also part of your new plan?
I want people to look at me and think,
pedophile.
Now there goes a stoic. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That's what that guy's eating bread and olives all day.
This guy has a great Socratic method and a lot of nut oils.
You lose enough weight, you grow enough beard, people just start throwing money at you on the streets.
I want people to look at me and go, he seems deliberative.
Now, how long are we talking? Give me like a reference point, like a DJ Sandhu beard? Or?
Yeah, like kind of down to like mid-chest.
Mid-chin, okay, yeah. All right.
It's going to be long and...
It's too much beard.
We'll braided, see. Little beard ponytail.
It's going to set me out in Hollywood, man.
I guess.
I can't believe you don't like Portland. Like, yeah. I you're like, I don't like Portland. Here's a list of things. It's the most Portland shit you've ever heard.
Growing a beard? Excuse me, I'm Arab. That's my thing, man. That's what I'm saying. It's going to help Hollywood really see me for who I could be. Terrorist on 24.
Yeah, I mean, you'll get more extra work, but I don't know if that's worth it.
I don't know, man. I've been driving for Lyft, so maybe it's worth it.
I gotta feel like that's gonna hurt your Lyft rating.
Let me tell you right now, dude. I've been driving for Lyft. I drove for Lyft the other day on Pride Day.
Yeah.
Here's how hurting I am for money. It was Pride Day.
He picked
Day
up
in
gay
West
people.
Hollywood.
Okay.
Tons of gay dudes I was picking up. All of them were flirting with me, and I was like, I am not going to reveal I'm straight to any of these people in hopes of getting a tip.
That's just good business, dude.
That's good business.
Yeah,
dude.
No, I don't blame you for that for a second.
I literally all day, they'd be like, you ever been to Akbar? And I'd be like, nah, that's just not my scene. Like, they'd be naming like clear gay bars.
I really hang out at the Eagle more.
Yeah.
Like, they'd be like, oh, we better not fuck with him.
I'd give them kind of the truth where I'd go, yeah, I don't know. It's not me.
You're playing hard to get. I love it.
Did you get tipped?
Got tipped pretty. The gay community is good. The only time the gay community is bad is occasionally you run into these guys who are like, you ever run into like gay guys who walk around like they're the star of their own sitcom?
Yeah.
Those are the only guys that got.
Well, dude, you know who's so fucking bad about that are drag queens?
Drag queens are
dude,
like
anytime, the public service knows, if you're a drag queen, like, Godspeed, do your thing. If you ever have to host a comedy show, just bring somebody up and then get the fuck out of the way. Don't try and do some fun, wacky, riffy interview. I did a show last night. It was like a Pride Week show. And it basically was this like big fat dude dressed like a fucking like blue face paint nun in drag who then just wanted to ask a bunch of weird questions about my dick before introducing me.
Jesus Christ.
I was like, getting me too'd by one of the aliens from the fucking Star Wars cantina.
It's just one of those things where it's like, I understand how your impulse, you think this is funny, but I promise you, it's not.
What
it's
is a beautiful
working.
Cocktail of just blind arrogance and complete lack of self-awareness.
Yeah.
I had to do a Postmates one time from the Abbey. It's like a big gay bar.
Oh, yeah.
And it's just like picking up some cookies. And like I walked in and it was like Wild West saloon doors open. Who's this new guy in town? Everyone just starts sniffing me out. They see me looking at my phone and they're like, uh-oh, is this an app or is this guy just a little shy? He doesn't have to be.
Is the Abbey a place where people order food and shit?
Fucking apparently.
Oh, yeah, I didn't know.
I think you'd want to go in there on an empty stomach.
Yeah. Like, I mean, it just feels like a... It feels like a weird
what
move
do you
to me.
Taste
like
the gay.
Yeah, I'd like to Postmates a handful of peanuts from Verdugo Bar. Like, you know, like what? Where are we Postmatesing bar food? You know, like
yeah, that's the whole point. Is you're at this bar, this is your only.
I would think so. Yeah. Oh wait, I'm gonna go back. I want to do another cookie thing. Right. Warning: these cookies contain nut.
We'll be right back right after this, guys.
I don't get it.
How the fuck are you, everybody? It's me, Mark Malloy. Man, 200 episodes of Mean Boys. Feels like just yesterday these three idiots climbed out of a dumpster in Orange County and into the hearts and minds of the world. The world has changed so much since the humble beginnings of America's 973rd most popular podcast. But through all the great moments in history, the Mean Boys have been there. Like this episode from The Vault, recorded way back in 1865.
All right, everybody, it's time for the Mexican Joke Off.
I give us Texas back.
I'll take us away this week. President Abraham Lincoln was shot in the head this week. He'll soon be buried 6 feet under, 8 feet if he's wearing the hat.
Man, imagine getting shot with your dick out. What a fucking bummer.
What are you talking about? He was at a theater.
Oh, like, for real? I thought the theater was code for jerking it in the back row. I guess that's only if you're Fred Willard.
I don't get that joke.
It'll be funny in 150 years.
I wouldn't say funny. You know, amusing tops.
The Mean Boys have always been there to tell us what's happening in this crazy world. To not only entertain, but inform, even when the truth is uglier than a dog fucking a lady in a warehouse. Like this unforgettable moment from 1943. Wait, so you mean to tell me they're just herding them on the trains, taking them to camps, and slaughtering them by the tens of thousands?
Correctamundo!
And who can forget that historic fucking episode in 1968 when those lovable Mean Boys went to Vietnam to record live from the front lines of the Tet Offensive.
Welcome back to the Mean Boys Podcast, one of our first ever on-location episodes. We're coming to you from a foxhole in Hanoi. Keith followed some ladyboy into the jungle and never came back, but we're joined by our guest...
Martin Jackson, Sergeant, United States Army. Welcome to the shit, boys.
What's it like out here, man? Seems pretty fucked up.
It ain't no fucking Easter picnic, fatty. You sleep in a hole, elbow to elbow, praying to God you don't get spotted by one of the snipers in the trees. Hell, some nights I catch myself praying they do spot me. One quick pop, one quick drop, and I get a body bag and a free ride home. I don't know how much more of this I can take.
Yeah, for sure. I took the biggest fucking shit. Before I forget, I took the biggest dump I've ever taken in my life yesterday. I don't know what they're putting in this Vietnamese food, but I left a couple punji sticks for you behind the mess hall.
Yeah, you get used to it. So anyway,
so shut up. Because the thing about the shit was, it looked like it was two different dumps sewn together, like a Nightmare Before Christmas dump, if I had to describe. Like, it started as diarrhea. And halfway through, it must have, like, rallied and came together like a spirit bomb in my ass. You know, like, it was like a little league team that learned to believe themselves halfway through the season because someone's mom died or
what. I'm trying to tell a story.
Yeah, and I'm trying to tell you that I don't care. I'm a professional broadcaster, and I know what the people want. It's hard-hitting, boots-on-the-ground reporting about the human rights atrocity my asshole just committed behind the Humvee.
Boy, you don't know nothing about pain. You ever seen the eyes of a child who's already seen death? The blank, cold, empty stare of a kid that learned there ain't no God and there ain't no mercy?
Do you know how many pizza places I've headlined in Fresno?
They made me take a blowtorch to an entire village, hearing the screams of the people boiling alive, watching myself do it from above like a ghost, unable to stop myself. I was only following orders. I was only following orders.
So, I'm guessing you didn't write new names?
No, I did it. New name for when you poop your pants because you got scared by the Viet Cong. Charlie Brown.
Okay, so he gets to talk about his dumps. When I do it, it's lazy. You're the worst. I'm glad you're going to get old sitting in front of a liquor store crying in a wheelchair.
We're going to take a quick break while I sign up for a 99-cent store credit card in Ramsey Badawi's name. But after the break, we'll take a look at more great moments in Mean Boys history. And the Mean Boys podcast returns. We just got a text from Opie that his back hurts.
Yeah, man. Opie, God bless him. I love him. The man gets hurt like a... Opie experiences all of his things in life like a 53-year-old man.
Yeah.
Like a 53-year-old divorced man. Every little thing, he's like, my toe hurts. I'll be out for 3 weeks. You won't hear from me.
Well, he's also got a lot of medicine opinions. You know, like he's like, and you're like, well, you take some ibuprofen, reduce the swelling, you know, maybe help you get to sleep. And he's like, I'm not trying to be Korean. You know, yeah. And you're like, okay.
I'll do ibuprofen. I heard that shit makes your dick softer.
Yeah, exactly.
You guys want to hear the fattest physical injury that I suffered yesterday?
Oh, yeah.
I walked into a Full Metal pole while eating a cheesesteak.
Wow.
I was at Boost Cheesesteaks, and I was like, I got your napkins. And I stand up, and there's just like a full pull behind me. So I just go, donk, and just fucking took myself out.
The only way that could have been fatter is if on the other side there was a fat guy with an ice cream cone, and you guys crashed into each other.
And he just grabs the cheesesteak on his way down.
And you, oh. And you guys bumped into each other and created a product that you both secretly want.
The ice cream Philly cheesesteak?
Yeah, dude.
And the owner was saying that
the Hogan Dazs.
The owner was just sitting there like, well, I guess I'm just moving my own piano now. All right, gang, we're all fired up. What do you say we get into the Mexican joke off?
Ay, so topical.
Yes. Let's do it. I'll take it away this week. An Echo Park family is facing trial from the neglect death of a special needs boy they kept in their closet, which is bullshit. Tom is fine.
Oh, no. I know that couple.
You know what's funny? I thought about doing the same joke. I have a different joke about that subject. I'm not going
to
do it.
What part, Echo? How close was it to our house?
I didn't look up the exact, but I
got to
think
one firework away.
Yeah. How many fireworks away?
Yeah,
I did see. I walked to the grocery store the other night, and like, there's this underpass on where the fucking good part starts, you know. And yeah. I was walking underneath it, and there was just a bird scooter that had been broken in half. like the war has begun, you know. Like it but it looked like it looked violent, you know.
It is, yeah. Its neck has been snapped. I've seen it before, and where you're like, oh no, dude.
I just got to figure like an old Mexican man who's lived here his entire life. He's like, no more, just broke it. Ah!
The neighborhood!
And threw it off the side, you know? It was fucking cool. I got a picture of it.
That rocks.
Okay, no, I'm not going to do that joke.
Do more narrate.
Yeah. No, that's what people want. They want to know the thought process.
Yeah.
I'm behind the actor's studio. A cheese sculpture was made of singer Carrie Underwood. Upon closer examination, it wasn't a cheese sculpture. It was just Adele.
That's actually really good.
By the way, behind the actor's studio is Kevin Spacey's new show.
That's a beautiful Adele slam.
Thank you. I love how long it took you guys to process what I was saying.
Well, I thought Adele, I was like, the computer?
Yeah.
And then I remembered that Adele's a fat lady we all
know.
A baby bell. She's made of cheese.
In Claremore, Oklahoma, a man was arrested after stabbing his stepfather over an energy drink. He was charged with aggravated assault, which incidentally is a new flavor by Monster Energy. Available today at Joke Offs, brought to you by 7-Eleven.
Oh, yeah, dude, misdemeanor battery. Misdemeanor batteries pretty much are what energy drinks are. That's what a Four Loko is. That is
absolutely.
That's a double A for, like, you know, throwing a rock at a cop.
Connor, yeah. You don't drink much. You ever have the original Four Loko?
No, I haven't.
Dude, I did a set on two Four Lokos.
It's eight locos.
It was a lot of locos, man. I killed in a ballet studio. It was fucking so much fun.
The craziest part, it was a bar. But
you know me, dude. I'm a libertarian. I'm as John Stuart Mill as the next guy. But that was the one time in government history when they stepped in that I was like, yeah, okay.
This needs regulation.
100%.
Well, it's the beverage equivalent of pushing your wife down some stairs. Like, it's fucking rough, dude.
I do like the, was it you that had the idea, like, you know that bottle of wine in Sideways, you know? It was you that was like, you were saving the original Four Loko, you know, for a special occasion.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, just on a mournful day drinking the last can of original, I don't know, date rape orange or whatever flavors they had.
It is something a rich guy would definitely do, have.
Rap sheet grape or whatever. All right, gang. An Australian professor has proposed a method for turning human poop into bricks. Building a home with lazy poop ideas? Back off, bitch. The mean boys are working this corner.
We're feces.
There you go.
No, this is the house that poop built.
Yeah.
By the way, I have gotten a surprising amount of DMs asking me to release the poop picture.
That's weird.
If you want it, just tweet me. I will send it to you.
I showed it to somebody at work because he asked about it.
What happened?
Who?
John.
Oh, John. Okay.
And I showed it to him and he just goes, and then walked away like he was not impressed.
Oh, what happened? What are you guys talking about?
Oh, it's the picture I showed you at Opie's party of my crazy poop.
Oh, yeah, that's right. You did show me that.
It's pretty nuts, right?
It was insane.
I'm glad I haven't seen it. I've taken some crazy dumps in my time.
A new company.
We're doing a Mean Boys clip show, and we're supposed to go back and see all the times you took a crazy dump.
I should take some photographic evidence
because
I didn't realize that this was a good way to network. We should.
If you think you have a dump that tops mine, we should all take a photo of it. You know, and lead up to some big, like, fucking Rocktoberfest poll or something, you know?
I want to collect a dump from every fan.
I took one that looked like a giant fudge caterpillar, and it looked like beefy anal beads.
Okay. Have you ever take one that looks like it has hair?
I took one of those today.
Oh, okay.
Where it was like, yeah, it was like solid, but it like had like weird frills to it. It looked like some sort of anemone.
Yeah, like a cowboy's jacket.
Yeah.
You know?
It had fringe.
Yeah.
Yeah, I get the spikes, like deflated porcupine things.
Oh, like a sad quill?
Yeah.
Oh, dude, this is gross.
Yeah.
Ramsey, you talk to us about oil. Fuck off. No. Yeah.
A new company is allowing people to buy lifelike sex dolls of their dead loved ones, which is heartwarming when it's your wife, but less so when it's your daughter.
Oh, that was good. Bulletproof backpacks are now available to children. Yeah, you wouldn't want your kids' books to get shot. You guys get it?
I mean, they are pretty expensive, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
According to a study by... According to a study by researchers at UCLA, energy drink consumption is linked to stimulant abuse. Oh, yeah, I'm doing all energy drinks.
Oh, good. Yeah,
hell yes.
Energy drink consumption is linked to stimulant abuse. As a consumer of energy drinks, let me be the first to say, stimulants are just one of the many things I abuse. There's my girlfriend. There's marijuana.
Oh, man. Yeah, I remember doing a Red Bull and some Ritalin before community college. Yeah. That shit was fucked. That was no joke. You're going 2,000 miles an hour sitting completely still.
Let me tell you right now, some of the best days of my life are when I think back to when I had a Ritalin prescription and energy drinks. God, they go well together, don't they?
Oh, dude. And you're just like, oh, I'm ready to take on the day.
Honestly,
that to me feels like one of those ice creams where there's too many different kinds of chocolate, but like for speed.
No, let me tell you, you're just literally like, they could not put enough life in front of me right now.
Absolutely. I have never felt, I've never had a more motivated half hour in my entire life. See, I mean, it is just an incredible, it is literally the fucking, I got the star in Super Mario of life.
Right.
See, if I want my heart to pound that hard, I just climb up some stairs. I don't need...
I look at a jungle gym.
All right, guys, Lil Nas X. Lil Nas X has been canceled because of anti-Muslim tweets on his old account, proving once and for all that Old Town Road is a country song.
That's a great fucking joke. A devoted Nazi in California was shot to death by his 10-year-old son. The boy was arrested, convicted, and has been sentenced to a pizza party.
Was he also sentenced with plagiarizing your life?
Yeah, exactly. I was like, oh, man, why did I think of that?
When did I tell you you could take my whole thing?
Did I ever tell you the time I thought about murdering my stepdad?
Which time?
Only in essence. Only in Strood.
He fucking, this is the Nazi one, so no one has to feel bad.
Yeah, so you actually planned at a point. Like, there was
I didn't really plan it, so here's what happened. He got in this, like, he had this thing he liked to do where he would drive around on a motorcycle hammered drunk. And he wrecked his motorcycle, and he broke, like, his fucking neck and his back and like, all this shit. So he had that fucking
the halo
headgear thing where it's, like, screwed into your skull.
They call it the halo.
Yeah, it's called, I know what it's called. I've read a lot of like paperwork on the fucking halo.
It's called the halo because he also said the N-word on it.
He's got the big plastic, like, fucking, like, chest piece he's got to wear all the time, like, fucking hateful Iron Man. But I hated this dude so much, and I was, like, fucking... 16 at this point, and I remember we were just there at the top of our stairs, and it was just like him at the top of the stairs, kind of drunk at our apartment, and I'm behind him, and I'm like, man, I could just shove him real quick, and no one would know I did that.
Damn, dude. Well, I mean, that's crazy. I can't.
Yeah, I didn't do it. But
I thought it was going to be like, wait till he's watching the football game and then just start tightening the screws. You know what I mean?
No, literally, he was so drunk. I'm like, I could have just like one elbow and he would have just been
what
done.
Well, the toxicology reports are going to be like, clearly there's some fat kid interference here.
What if you ended up tightening the screw so much that he just became like very progressive?
Oh, I hit his woke gland.
You hit a woke thing in
you Homer Simpsoned
him. He finds out and it's like Homer with the crayon in his brain. It's like, well, would I fix my brain to be racist again?
So funny.
All right, one screw, libertarian, two screw. I'm back, baby.
Oh, no.
A South African flight was grounded after an abandoned fetus was found blocking the toilet. Do you guys know that in South Africa, fetuses flush the opposite direction than America?
They're like, hey, lady, you only get one piece of carry-on on this flight.
Coca-Cola Company released its first energy drink. You guys hear about this?
Tell me more.
They're apparently testing it in Australia. When reached for a comment, spokesperson for the soft drink company said, it was real easy. We just ended up putting the Coke back in the drink. It kind of came full circle.
Keep Christ and Christmas and keep Coke and Coca-Cola.
Yeah.
If you think about it, they really did have the first energy drink, and we don't give them props.
They were ingenues.
Listen, energy drink history is a fascinating subject. I'll be teaching it in a community college near you.
Intro to Red Bull.
I honestly believe if you grow this beard, you could scam your way into a history
of
energy drinks.
You know how many people with GEDs will get their associates if you pull this off, Ramsey?
Oh, my
Class,
God.
Class, I like to think I'm here to give your mind wings.
I really didn't know until recently that, like, every soda has caffeine in it.
Yeah.
I really didn't think that. I thought they just had a bunch of sugar. I didn't know it was all like, caffeine,
doesn't.
Too.
Presumably.
Sprite does not.
Presumably, the caffeine is to be addictive.
Yeah.
It's like, oh, it gives me a mood kick or whatever.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. God bless him. Great stuff.
Anyhoozle, a 26-year-old woman killed her 3-year-old son with her SUV. She told authorities they were playing chicken. The chicken she was playing was Mel Gibson's one in Chicken Run.
I don't like claymation.
Yeah.
Yeah. Have we ever talked about this on the show? Has this ever come up?
It's a decent movie, though.
Chicken Run. I love that movie.
Good.
It's like one of my favorite childhood movies.
Because it is just the great escape. It's a Nazi prison movie
right.
with chickens.
I got to tell you, post-canceled Mel Gibson movies are a lot of fun. I have only seen The Beaver and Get the Gringo, but goddamn if I did not have a hilarious time watching those movies.
I want to see this one where he's playing Santa Claus that's coming.
Oh, I know. Yeah, I mean, it's like, dude, we're back, baby. You know, it's
he's making a movie where he plays Santa, which anything to keep him away from Jewish people's houses.
Sure.
That's fine.
Sure.
I've heard of bad
you
grandpa, but anti-Semitic grandpa?
Speaking of which, a Holocaust survivor died in a traffic accident in Los Angeles. Police are calling it a classic case of Hitler and Run.
I like that. A man attacked his wife in a brutal sledgehammer attack. Be on the lookout for a 6-foot gorilla with Super Smash Bros. Power-up music playing behind him.
Man, there's no such thing as a non-brutal sledgehammer
yes.
attack.
Oh, he's so gentle with the hammer.
There's no misdemeanor sledgehammer
yeah,
assault.
You know there was intent and a lot of it before that murder.
There are two ways a sledgehammer attack goes. I killed that lady or I missed. Like, that's the only options.
Yeah, I have a sledgehammer and I have a hammer minus, and the sledgehammer is way harder to swing. It takes a lot of effort.
A hammer minus?
Yeah, like one of those nail hammers.
A hammer.
Well, yeah, they're all hammers.
Normal, a non-sledgehammer.
Well, each could be a hammer.
You don't call
the
sledgehammer the hammer plus.
Well, no, it's already called sledgehammer.
Yeah, but and the hammers are called hammers.
Right.
What is hammer minus? Arsenio Hall?
Hammer minus sounded like you played in the Herbie Hancock's band. You know?
They're both
yeah, I don't
hammers,
know why
so you'd have to differentiate between
I don't know why
the
they
hammers.
Did my report card in Wingdings. I got a hammer minus in geometry.
Hammer minus is the grade I got in shapes.
Yeah.
All right, here, it's my turn, right?
Yeah.
A woman in Scotland... Now, this is a crazy story. You guys are going to love this. A woman in Scotland drank so many energy drinks that she actually became paralyzed, landing her in an Edinburgh hospital, but more importantly, landing her a place in my heart.
That was a sweet
one. The opposite direction.
It really
was.
It was
very sweet. I like that one.
Yeah. But seriously, though, her nervous system appears to be really damaged.
She should grow wings.
Apparently, your spinal cord cannot take that much B12. It's really bad for you.
Wait, it's just too much ginseng. That's the problem.
You know, they tried to megadose me with B12.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Dude.
To what, turn you into the Hulk?
To turn me out of crazy.
Oh.
It didn't work.
It's true, dude. Have you ever never noticed?
Well, putting vitamins on Tom's brain, that's like, you know, that's a Dixie cup on a forest fire.
I just metabolized them. It didn't help my sanity.
His pee actually got clearer. We don't know what to do with this guy.
It did. One time I took niacin. You guys ever take niacin on an empty stomach?
I don't know that I've ever taken niacin.
I was screaming in pain.
Yeah, niacin
was
rough.
I took it on an empty stomach.
What is niacin?
And I was just like crying and punching the floor and just fucking screaming. It was the most pain I've ever been in.
It's a vitamin. It might be a mineral, which actually why it will, if you take it on an empty stomach, like speed up your heart rate. You'll get all flush.
That's okay.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. No, you just get red. And I took it. And I was taking like a prescribed amount.
Yeah.
Like the I was in so much fucking
pain. I did the
pain.
Same with zinc when Opie one time convinced me
that
zinc would give me a raging hard on.
I've also had some experience with this issue.
Had a real rough. I got so sick. Did you get sick from it or no?
If you take it on an empty stomach,
it'll
you'll
make
be
you
fucked
sick,
up.
Dude.
You'll feel like shit, dude.
I remember looking it up.
I
got to put
the
fact a sandwich
that
on that.
Opie can write home and be like, "Dear family from Nigeria, today I tricked a bunch of white people into pissing metal." Like that's
also like Gordon Ramsay white people.
I will say
he wants it.
That I feel like zinc gave me more. Jizz?
You believe that's true?
In my experience, because I know a typical amount of jizz for me,
fair.
A post zinc jizz was certainly frothier than a typical outing.
I don't
you
need
know?
More jizz. Every Froth. Time I come, I got put down that slippery floor sign. Like it's a hazardous amount of cum.
Frothy, like the bubbles on top of an orange Julius.
Well, yes.
Well, we know when Opie eventually has the money to open up his own research institute, this will be one of the things studied.
Oh, absolutely.
It is
yeah.
an Opie, like, firm belief.
I went like 10 days without blowing the other day, which Opie's gone like years or whatever, like with his weird shit. And it's like, my cum came out like yellow and brown. And I'm like, this is, you gotta do a little bit of valve releasing because it's fucking fermenting in there.
It can't be good for you.
Like Opie has an IPA in his nuts.
There's a reason why the Boston Bombers used a pressure cooker.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Pressure is dangerous.
It really is. All right, guys.
Oh, I was just going to ask you, Keith, which Def Jam comic is Orange Julius?
I was so funny.
In we're my, going back for
in my periphery. I saw you two coordinating. I was like, "What's going on over here?"
Was, like ever since I said Orange Julius, he was just vibrating with joy. And I'm like, "Well, let's find out about the cum first, and then we'll come back for the pun."
I had to explain to one of my coworkers who Alonzo Hamburger Jones was, and by the time I was done, just her face was just like, "Is this what you do with your time?"
The black community's Weird Al.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, shit.
That's wow.
Yeah.
All right, guys. The Palestinian people have rejected Trump's $50 billion economic peace plan. A related story, Ramsey is about how he's looking for new energy drink money or whatever. You get it. Well, you get it.
Yeah,
I just wanted to see what you thought about the Jared Kushner Palestinian peace plan.
If anybody...
I didn't really read about it, but apparently it was some kind of like it was seemed bad. I don't know,
if anybody's
going to
negotiate peace in the Middle East, it is one of the anchovies from SpongeBob.
He's actually the original version of the NPC man, just a gray soulless man.
Yeah.
Look, man, I know where my bread is buttered. I'm pro-Israel now. Let's just move on, okay?
The FDA has approved a new pill that increases the sex drive of women. So ask your doctor for a prescription for that new miracle drug, money. That Orange Julius wrote that joke, actually.
2001 closer.
hold up. It's the Chive calling. I got to tell you. You want how much? Not enough.
Give me a time machine and Daniel Tosh's phone number.
You're going to be on every gas station TV from here to New Mexico, kid.
Somewhere Tucker Max is listening to this podcast, crumpling up a piece of paper and throwing it away.
Entire book. He threw away the entire book.
I hope they don't have podcasts in hell.
A giant 14-inch goldfish was found in a river near Buffalo. The city is using it as a PSA not to flush your pet fish down the toilet, since it can end up in the river and spread bacteria. The city of Buffalo clarified, poop is fine. There is no bacteria in poop. Fish are obviously cleaner than poop, since there is poop in your butt, but no fish in your butt. We will not be fixing the major sewage issue. We will be too busy with this filthy fishdemic. Thank you, Buffalo.
I like when you watch Tom read the jokes, and you could very clearly tell when his eyes have to go from this side of the page over to this side of the page, like when you're watching someone read teleprompter for the first time. It's like an ISIS hostage video. I mean, you can tell the dudes have bad handwriting.
Well, what's even better?
I confess my loyalty to the Islamic state. Context. I
thought
it
said Islamic Strood for a second.
Here's the problem with me and handwriting, okay? I was a kid, I was very, very, very paranoid. So I wrote everything in notebooks. But I made my handwriting too messy so that people could not read it over my shoulder.
Sure.
Now I have to read jokes, and this is me trying to be neat, and it's a fucking nightmare. the point is... Mental health is bad, I guess, is the point.
Yeah, there you go.
I
did not have a fifth joke, and I think that's what you should have closed this.
You know what? Mine was
with.
Longer than three jokes, so yeah, I donate half my winnings to Ramsey.
I don't have a fifth joke, but I do have a quip I've been thinking about lately.
Oh, all right. Oh, okay.
I've got amusing.
Nice.
I do have amusing.
Ramsey's musing calling.
I'm fine. I'm
you
fine.
Don't? You have no music?
I mean, I got musing.
Are you all right, buddy?
The
you
people
love
came
the muse.
Here for a Ram Dog Ponderance. Now fucking...
Yeah.
Give us the goods.
Let's listen.
Pontificate.
Let's come. I know I have some musings in my phone. Let's go back with the mailbag, and I'll before we get started, I'll open up with a musing. Okay.
All right. That sounds good.
Building a lot of hype
is
for
it. A muse is an inspiration, right?
Yes. For a second, I was going to yell at you, and then I realized.
Yeah, muse is like something. Yeah, it is something. A musing is like a little thought about something, yeah. You know?
I was like, the band Muse has never inspired anybody. I can do anything but turn off the band Muse.
It's a band?
Yeah, they suck, dude.
That's so funny.
yeah, I'm really sticking it. I'm going back to 2001 with that one, too.
Dude, leave prog rock alone.
Dude, I'm coming for Coheed and Cambria next.
All right, I got one more here that's pretty whatever. A zoo in Nigeria is being investigated for their claims that a cash-eating gorilla lost them $20,000. A cash-eating gorilla is also what the Patriots called Gronk when he got injured and couldn't play for a season.
That's a great joke.
He's still under contract.
Yeah.
I'm a sports guy now. I do sports stuff, you know?
Well, yeah, we're jocks because being nerds is lame now.
Yeah, man. I've been watching a lot of basketball stuff. I don't even know who the fuck I am anymore.
Whoa, my mom just sent me a photo of a deer.
All right.
It's blurry.
Okay, why did she say? She didn't take that. That is a photo of a television with a deer on it.
No, she took it. It looks very Van Gogh-y. No, Picasso?
Not
who,
Picasso.
Who,
no.
Who draws in points? Who's the point?
I know who you're talking about.
Bob Ross?
No. He's about bushes.
No, like the point of it, like the fucking Ferris Bueller.
I know
painting.
This.
Yeah.
Who's point?
Is it Magritte?
Magritte?
Magritte is a guy.
Is the Indian guy Magritte? Trying to order a McGriddle again?
Magritte?
That's like, why I started laughing.
I would like to order.
Who's the pointillism guy?
Pointillism is there's not. No way.
I think that is what it's called, actually.
It is, yeah.
All right.
Eat my strood. It's pointillism.
It's called pointillism. Dude, Tom is 100% right.
Tom just strooded all over our noodles.
I have to pee.
Surratt is the guy you're thinking
Surratt, there we go. Yeah, there you see the deer?
I don't care. The Meme Boys podcast, we'll be right back.
Welcome back to Meme Boys, a look back. I'm Mark Malloy, unless you're with a collections agency, in which case my name is Farooq Khabib, and please take me off your fucking call list. Let's listen to this unforgettable clip from the Meme Boys episode recorded on September 11, 2001.
I'm just saying, maybe we can all stop calling me a bad driver. Those guys are bad drivers. I've hit a couple Camrys, but I've never hit a fucking building.
Are we recording?
Hey, guys, sorry I'm late. I overslept. I didn't have time to get coffee or read the paper or anything. I saw Ramsey dancing on the roof when I came in. Anybody know what that's about?
Hey, let's do voicemails.
Hey, Meme Boys. It's Short Flight Murphy. They're going to crash the plane. We're going to rush them and try to take control. If we don't make it, tell my family I love them. And big ups to the Fudge Lord. All right, let's roll.
But as bright as the past is, it's nothing compared to the future for fucking Meme Boys. Enjoy this sneak peek at an episode recorded in the year 3019, long after the rise of the machine overlords.
Hey, everybody. Welcome to the Meme Boys podcast. We're human consciousness trapped in robot prisons, the dark inevitability of the techno-singularity made reality. I'm Connor McSpadden.
I was once Keith Carey, but I'm now the flesh pod designated 24601.
And I am Tom Drawn 9000.
Dude, we've been uploaded to the cloud for like 500 years. Can you stop talking like that?
Error. I got uploaded into a cheaper model, which can only speak in robot voice.
Oh, yeah, I forgot we put Tom's brain in the Matrix version of a Zune. All right, let's just do lightning round. Tom, 30 seconds on the clock. Name 10 poisons.
Processing. Complete. 3.7 million results found. Begin information dispensing.
Oh, fuck that. Let's just go to a sketch. Great machine. Run program Karnok.exe.
Wretched pig children! Ready your hard drives for a forced download of amusing adjectives!
Oh, this show sucks. I'll be vaping in the holodeck if you need me. Don't need me.
So here's to the Meme Boys and their enduring legacy of thumbing it in every fucking Tuesday. I'm Mark Malloy, and don't call the cops.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Meme Boys podcast is back, and it is time for the Meme Boys mailbag.
It's the Meme Boys mailbag. Fuck everything. God is dead. Send us an email or give us a call. Have you ever heard the one about Keith and the dog? It's the motherfucking Meme Boys mailbag.
There's our jingle.
Yeah.
All right, guys. Oh, we got it. I was promised amusing. I almost forgot.
Here's what I'm going to say. Unfortunately, I don't got amusing, but I do have a business idea I'd love to talk before.
Did I tell you guys about how I kicked a sprinkler drunk smoking a cigar with my dad?
No.
That is
no, but what?
I but I love that you waited for a good opening.
Sorry. I just remembered.
You just cut off an ambulance.
Like, when Tom has a thought, it's like he's holding something really hot. And he's like, I got to do... It's going to be gone in a second if I don't put it down.
Immediately, I forget it.
Yeah.
That's why I'm always writing.
All right, Pigeon Man.
So I remember what I forgot.
Tell me the thing.
Oh, that was it. It just cut a giant cut off my foot.
Your barefoot? When was this?
No, I was wearing sandals.
When did this happen?
I just peeled the scab off. You can
so recently, that is not okay. Still within one scab's amount of time
yeah.
is the answer you indirectly gave me
yes.
to my very direct question.
2 weeks ago.
Okay, fun.
I was in Chicago for a wedding.
Gotcha.
Yeah, it was a nice wedding. Sometimes go
good,
Ramsey.
Good.
Sometimes this podcast feels like I'm on the potluck at the Comedy Store. Like I'm either following something brilliant or an insane chef from from the back.
Oh, fucking the El Tocho of comedy, yeah, yeah. fucking top guys.
Yeah, so let's hear this business
well,
idea.
I'm in the pretty early stages of you guys. Listen,
man,
you don't gotta
amazing.
Be. You Sorry, don't gotta guys. Subscribe to Forbes magazine to know you gotta be in the subscription game in the future, right?
Yeah,
we gotta be in the subscription game.
You gotta have a. You gotta put something in a box and do it every month.
You gotta do it every yeah. month. I'm currently
just
I'm
like
actually,
marriage.
Yeah. Hey, but one step further. What if it's a box? But there's no box. It's an app. Boom. All the fucking
you
money.
Give them
you
a new app every month?
No, it's one app, but they subscribe every month.
Okay.
And they get it. What do they get?
Well, it's a meditation app. It's my own meditation app. What's different?
From the most well-adjusted Zen guy around.
Well, what's different? You're thinking, what's different about this app than Headspace and all the other ones? I'll tell you what's different. This one is a meditation and a hookup app.
Okay.
It lets you hook up with nearby people who are also into meditating.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
It's like OKCupid meets Buddha. It's OK Buddha.
Jism of peace.
This is a 1993 men show sketch.
This is like a second era Rogan and Stanhope. If they're not trying anymore, era man show sketch.
Listen, I get high. I write things down. I love it.
I like it.
Yeah. Thanks,
can you man. Just have the app and not meditate or fuck?
I guess so.
Because yeah. I want to support you, but I'm not interested in what you're interested in.
Either of those things.
I mean, who better to guide you through quiet meditation than a fucking Arab on Ritalin? The loudest, fastest creature alive.
I'll have you know, Dr. Weiss no longer prescribes me Ritalin.
I'm stealing it from high school children.
When did you get a real doctor?
Oh, you didn't see the air
with
quotes?
Good ideas.
Well, he's a bit, it's a video thing. You don't really talk to the guy.
I
you
mean,
know.
He's more of what we technically call a vet. But
I went to one of those shady like clinics and,
right.
and then even that doctor was like, you know, I don't think so. Not for
Wait, that's why all Ramsey's pills say take with kibble on the bottle.
Not thinking dog Ritalin.
I was confused by this.
Dude, I've had this spaced out pooch. I've gotten him on dog Ritalin.
Dude, my dog smoking. Is just not productive enough.
Guys, I'll tell you what, razor sharp when I'm home, dude.
He's not licking his balls quick enough.
Yeah,
I don't
mean,
know. Maybe you go to a service dog and provides more service. And yeah. There's purpose.
That's a fair point.
Yeah. Or it's just hauling ass, dragging a blind man down the goddamn street.
Are you,
well,
I'm
just
imagining.
With my experience with Ritalin, the dog is going to hump your leg forever and never come.
Here's, that, why, here's why you know giving a dog Ritalin is a bad idea. It is literally a plot point from There's Something About Mary. It's
yeah.
the thing they do to make the dog bad.
Absolutely, yes. Yeah,
I'm
yeah,
imagining
yeah.
now a dog running down the street at like full speed. But it's still dragging its ass on the sidewalk the whole way.
Sparks.
All right, guys. Angel Escalante asked, do you guys ever see yourselves reaching the 1,000 episode mark?
Fuck no.
No. Nope.
Christ, no. I mean, look, I do very much enjoy doing this show, but if that, like thinking of doing it for five times longer than we've been doing it now seems insane.
Do you think about it. That is 15 years of Mean Boys.
Yeah.
They didn't make 15 years of good things. Oh, you, know,
yeah. you know what? You know what?
It was like three seasons of Mr. Show.
Yeah, you know what didn't go 15 years? Friends. So yeah. like.
Yeah, I think, yeah, no is the answer.
Yeah.
Does it bother you to know, though, that in the 200 episodes of Mean Boys that you did, you collectively did over 300 times more writing than anybody on Friends ever did? Like,
oh,
as a series. They literally.
Well, yeah, they just went, I don't know, Ross is a dick. That's lunch.
Was the I thought the monkey was the monkey season one?
I believe so.
You see, that feels like such a season six move.
No, they well, well they started off much wackier and then they really settled into the groove. And
yeah,
we're just gonna keep doing the same thing.
Monkey is also a good way of being like, look, I got no cards on the table. Here are all my cards. They're all on the table. Yeah. We got nothing.
If you open with monkey, it's like, where do you go next?
Yeah.
You know.
But you gotta remember, this is an era where having a monkey on a show felt like a game-changing revelation.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, we've come a long way.
This is pre-the monkey boom of 2003, like Newgrounds era internet.
Dude, wow.
Oh, yeah, I was there for that, man. I watched the rise and fall of monkey humor, dude.
I mean, you had to be there, man. Monkeys, pirates, ninjas. It was the CBGB of shitty dudes in Hawaiian shirts.
There was a year there in seventh grade where we couldn't believe it.
Did you guys ever play Ninja?
Like...
Oh, I know what you're talking about.
That game fucking ruled.
I forget. How does it work again?
Arcade game?
You put out your hands, and one person moves at a time, and the goal is to slap another person's hand, and they're out. But you can only react or move if it's your turn.
Oh, it's kind of one of those psych-out games?
Yeah. So if you move when it's not your turn, you're automatically out. Or react to something that didn't happen, you're automatically out.
Okay.
And it's just like, I'll show you. This is not a on-air thing.
It is insane what people did before.
You'll love it.
Porn.
Connor won't like it. I think you'd be good at it, though.
Great. So... Manic Pixie Dream Cobra asks, how is the energy drink going? What flavor profile does he want? Who is his dream spokesperson?
Well, first of all, thank you very much, Manic Sparkle Pixie.
Yeah, whatever.
Well,
it's
we're,
Dream Snake.
We're yeah. in the, we're
Manic Fuck Shit Ding Dong.
We're still in the R&D phase, like I said. We did find a manufacturing plant just outside of Chernobyl, and it's a relatively
The R&D phase is Ritalin and driving for Lyft.
We found a company that's willing to produce the drink and skirt around some of the FDA laws that we ran into in the beginning.
Yeah, sure.
The FDA.
Who's R&D?
R&D stands for Research and Development.
Oh.
In terms of flavor,
Should we be R-A-D?
We're going to start doing some focus grouping. If you guys are interested in focus grouping, email me johnbenet@ramseybadawi.com. I'll hit you back.
Yep.
I'll mail you an unmarked vial of mystery goo.
I will absolutely.
Ramsey, the R&D stands for reading Vice articles and doing vape tricks. That is very important. That is where all the good ideas come from. That's where the business percolates and takes form. But spokesman, I mean, who is the face of Rock Bard?
I thought about this. John Mayer. John Mayer.
Okay.
Oh, that's
all right.
So perfect.
I need somebody that oozes the sort of like sexual charisma and insecurity that this drink promises to.
It says I have to have enough swagger that you don't notice how lame my dick is.
I have enough swagger so you don't know that I don't know how I feel about dick.
I'm not good at eating pussy, but I'll talk about it a lot.
Tenzin Harhouse wants to know, what is your favorite sex toy? I have not used that many sex toys, but I did like the vibrating cock ring.
I've used the vibrating cock ring. That's fun.
I used it for the first time recently.
I used the vibrating cock ring. You know what I like about the vibrating cock ring? It's like it's a toy that we can all have fun with. Like, let's all just go.
Yeah.
It has a rumble pack. It's awesome, man.
Yeah. it's made by Mad Cats. This is amazing.
Exactly.
I did have a fucking situation where a girl I was seeing, I bought one and I was like, oh, this would be fun, you know, like spice it up in the bedroom, and then I pull it out and she's like, why the fuck are you? You clearly used this on someone before. It's out of the packaging. And I was like, I just opened it early because I can't think of anything that kills the mood worse than opening clamshell packaging. You know, like, all right, hey, I know everyone's hot and heavy, but let me get this new Xbox controller out.
You have a kitchen knife. I'm just going to kind of hack through it.
Here's what cracks me up about manufacturing is when you start to look at companies and you kind of go upward, you find out that there's like only three manufacturing companies on the planet.
Right.
Whoever makes cock rings, I guarantee you also makes ring pops. I guarantee you. And they're packaged in the same place.
They have a round mold.
With similar, like, I guarantee you.
No
it's
one's
just like,
changing the gloves.
They go just different directions.
Yeah.
Just like whoever makes Easter eggs also makes the little pot. Like things you snap open, like
oh yeah.
Sort of,
what was the fucking bit I had about that when we were at the Gateway Show?
Oh,
I said something that was so funny,
dude. I got me and Connor.
Oh yeah. You're like you were saying the Easter egg people when they find out about the weed cases.
Oh yes.
And I was like, that's like when the people that make fireworks found out about Mexicans.
They were like, yes,
a whole new market.
So funny.
I've never used a sex toy.
Really?
No.
How about a funny lube?
Never used lube.
A funny lube?
You know these fucking goofball
like
ones.
Tony Shalhoub?
Funny lube is shit.
There's all these wacky Tony Shalhoub.
You know what?
That's one of the funniest things you've ever said in your life.
Favorite sex toy is a condom. And even then, I don't like it very much.
Favorite sex toy, her name was Deborah.
You ever do the fire and ice?
Oh, yeah, no, I've done all the wacky, like... tingle lube.
You spank her with the George R. R. Martin book.
The one that turns your dick invisible for a second, like you're trying to sneak around in fucking Metal
Gear.
Like.
Icy hot. Why am I treating my girlfriend's pussy like it's a pitcher's elbow?
They have one that like it's like tingly, and then when you put it in the pussy, it activates some sort of fucking tingle gland in her.
Yeah, it makes it like kind of hot.
Not my
like, kinda,
favorite.
Yeah, it's weird. All right. It's weird.
You ever eaten the flavored lubes?
No.
They're not great.
Weed lubes. What are your
just
thoughts
on that?
Package.
The devil's go-gurt.
Keith, I know you've done weed lube, right?
Oh, yeah.
Does that make you feel high?
It was more of a CBD type thing, so it was kind of like, it was like very low cannabis and mostly CBD, so I was just kind of like tingly, like very chilled out.
I want to do that shit, but my girlfriend is definitely, she doesn't hang with pot well. Like, I wouldn't start there. Yeah.
I wouldn't start with, well, you're not comfortable smoking.
Look,
it. What if we shove it up your
pussy? I'm just going to
buy
what
if we, yeah. 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 That's like, look, I'm not big on pharmaceutical drugs. What about a suppository? Let's ease you in.
One beer makes me drunk, so I'm not going to have whiskey unless you pour it directly into my asshole.
Guys, a lot of cities in California are banning flavored tobacco products. By the way, this guy put that in quotes, tells you his opinion, a.k.a. vape juice. And San Francisco has outright banned sale of vapes. What's your opinion on the current state of vape rights, and what can the average man do to fight this?
Well, it's obviously abysmal. Is this to me or is this to everybody? I'll wait for you guys.
A vape rights thing? I went to the Arclight last night to see Toy Story, and the fucking guy comes out who does his little, hey, I'm at the Arclight. Hopefully they'll read my screenplay one day. And he's doing his whole thing, and he's like, and I know, but no one can vape. And somebody behind me just goes, he's so indignant.
It's bullshit. It's because
he planned to vape through a screening of Toy Story 4 at 11:30 at night.
I love that. Did you see Toy Story 4, by the way?
Yeah.
Was it good?
Yeah, it was pretty good.
Okay, I'll check it. Here's the thing. The state of vape rights is abysmal. They're coming for. Here's the problem. We let them go after the smokers.
Keith and Cutter pulled out their phones and started looking through.
It's my dad's birthday. I have to.
Is it really your pop's birthday?
It is, yeah.
I'm texting Connor's dad for his birthday, too.
Well, here's the thing. I think that we let them come after the smokers, and we said nothing, and now it's over for us. And now we just have to do what our other fellow civil rights activists did. You just got to vote pro vape.
Yeah,
that's why I support Marie Le Pen of France. She vaped, and sure, she's anti-immigrant and pro-slavery, but ultimately, you know,
I mean,
pick your battles.
What is a vapeless world if not slavery?
Why'd they outlaw it?
You're gonna let us vape once a year on Christmas?
What are these? Who gives? Keith. Could you care? I mean, you smoke, so I guess it doesn't
matter. You've started 90 different questions. What are you asking?
Who cares?
About vaping?
It's called debate, Keith, okay?
Yeah.
And I thank you to respect the rhetorical art.
I don't give a shit if anyone
thank
vapes.
You, Connor. You guys know I was a speech and debate champion in community college.
I could have guessed.
Now, that being said, it just meant I had to be better at debating than the kid with cerebral palsy who worked at McDonald's who was in the class with me. Smarter than me, but I was quicker to the draw, you know? But anyways.
All right.
Appreciate the question. Keep them coming.
Do you have any more people that you've been dying to have on the show? Any big get guests or friends in comedy that you've been meaning to have appear? No. I think we've gotten everybody.
Yeah. I don't know if there's anybody huge that I really want to get on.
No one huge. I have friends I'd like to get on.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't really love having famous people on the show because it sort of makes it... It's like too much, not pressure, but it's just kind of like
it's
a whole extra level of shit to have to feel like I can't really be myself.
Some of them have been fun. Like
the
episode is one of the most fun things I've ever done.
But it's hard to retain their attention to explain the show to them.
I'd love
Yeah, well, I mean, yeah, I mean, a lot of our more famous guests, I've, you know, sat down and been like, hey, so this is what the show is. And they go, great. And then they get here and they're like, what?
I'd like to have Tim Dillon on a third time, but this time he's just asleep. We just do it while he's just like reading the paper.
I think
it'd
be funny to have Kyle
Kinane
on and see if he remembers that he already did this.
That would be pretty funny.
He remembered me.
Oh, that's right. Yeah. What did he say to you? Like, you're the guy who was.
I saw him at Rec Room. I'm like, hey, man, how you doing? I was like, I know you. How do I know you? I'm like, Mean Boys. And he goes, I know you. You're that guy who lives in that crusty house.
I saw him at Good Heroin, and I talked to him. I was like, oh, you're at my house recording that podcast or whatever. And he's like, I was so happy to see that fucking house. He's like, people were still being punk rock.
That rocks pretty
well. People are still not doing the dishes or respecting themselves.
I still think he thinks I'm retarded, though. I'm like pretty sure.
What?
I think he thinks.
No.
I'm not saying that as a bit. I think he genuinely thinks I'm mentally Daft.
By the way, he walked away.
I did. What you missed was Tom doing his little Mr. Burn fingers when he said daft after he censored himself for the word he already said two times.
It's not about censoring.
Okay.
It's about finding. You got to really bring in a different. You know, if you bring in a charcuterie board, you don't want it to just be one kind of cheese. You got to put in the verbal meat variety for the sentence.
Okay, a charcuterie board is just poppers and prep.
I'm sorry, I started texting Connor's dad. What's going on?
You're now a food scientist for a renowned American fast food chain. If given near unlimited money for R&D, what concoction would you create to make it so my dad loves me? Okay, that's cop out answer. The cop out end of the quote. But what fast food item do you want that does not currently exist?
I'll go first. Hard boiled eggs.
I'm actually 100% with this. I get 7-Eleven hard boiled eggs sometimes, and I'm like, this feels wrong. I need something a little more stable.
A little more stable. There's something you got to get in hard boiled eggs sometimes. Sometimes you got to fucking get those macros up. You know,
I will like straight up fucking Lydia Hirsch kidnap the Jack in the Box guy if he brings back the ciabatta sandwich with the fucking
the
spicy chicken ciabatta sandwich. Sandwich. Those were fucking insane. I would like walk 3 miles to fucking get one back when I was like 13.
Yeah,
they were
fucking slapped.
Nuts.
Fucking
should
good.
Not have been a limited menu option.
Yeah.
And you fucked with me by keeping them around for a year, thinking you'd made them a permanent part of your menu,
yeah.
And then took them away again.
Oh, I got spoiled with the
to create artificial fucking scarcity in this market. And when it's like, I'm a guy that's just trying to eat quick. You know, I have a lot of life to live. I'm in a hurry, and you fucking took away my favorite fast on the go option. It needs to come back, and it needs to come back now. Make this right, Jack in the Box.
They did that to me with the mushroom Swiss burger from McDonald's, where I was like, this is a high quality fucking mid-range option.
The McDonald's like artisanal burgers.
Yeah, and they took them off the fucking
the
docket.
Pico guacamole was great.
Yeah.
That was a great fast food option.
They like Strapple waffle or something like that is
what?
Really good.
Oh, they're like, yeah, the McDonald's around the world menu, like with
yeah.
the Stroop waffle and stuff.
Yeah,
where like,
that's how you say it.
What is
yeah.
Stroop waffle?
Stroop waffle
I don't
is
know, but it's
you ever that thing where your pussy gets infected and it's all big?
You ever fly Delta?
Yes.
The snack they give you, that like kind of like weird, like a waffly looking snack?
Yeah,
that's a Stroop waffle.
It's just it's caramel crunch McFlurry.
It's the kind of exotic dessert that's a little bit salty and sweet and crunchy that I think you would really appreciate.
Guy, can we go get those
it's
right
really
now?
Good,
I'm
dude.
Down.
They put it in like a milkshake and shit, I'm sure. But yeah, Stroop waffles are good.
You guys want to really knock your fucking socks off? Go to Trader Joe's, get the cookie butter.
Oh, we know cookie butter.
Do you guys have used cookie butter? It's
yeah.
Cookie butter,
one time,
dog.
After
she was,
I was
season
sad
four
about
of RuPaul's Drag
whole
Race,
jar in one night,
dude. How good is fucking cookie butter? I'm only bringing it up because
I wish I'd got Nutella instead. It was a lot of butter.
What
butter
a ringing endorsement! Yeah, cookie butter.
I've not tried this cookie butter.
Well, the cookies that they make the cookie butter out.
It's basically so cookie butter is those.
You know, that's all like the hot dog parts of the cookies. You know,
they've made it into a butter. Those Stroop waffles and fucking Biscoff cookies.
Okay,
they've made it into like a spreadable butter.
No. Fucking way.
It fucking it bangs.
You know
what? It's too something for me.
The problem with McDonald's and all of the fast food places, they no longer innovate. Now all they do is they go like, check us out. We're McDonald's. Have you heard of a double cheeseburger? It's triple now. It's quadruple. It's like they just add meat. That's when they go one fucking patty extra.
Yeah, I mean, well, KFC, I feel like, is still innovating. They'll do weird shit every once in a while.
KFC innovates.
Well, they got the Cheeto sandwich that's hit the marketplace, you know.
That thing looks like a fucking hate crime.
Which, I mean, I'm surprised they didn't go right to Flaming Hot.
I just realized.
Yeah, well, I guarantee you, because the Cheeto sandwich, if you haven't, Google Cheeto sandwich at KFC if you haven't. It's a chicken sandwich with Cheetos on it.
It looks like gritty.
I guarantee you the normal one's going to come out because they're releasing it in New York or something. The Flamin' Hot is going to come out in this neighborhood in 2 months because they're going to test market the Flamin' Hot one in Latino neighborhoods.
This is where you this is where you do the
minorities love Flamin' Hot Cheetos. This is not a race.
I love
that. Is true.
It is true. As if minorities are not going through enough struggle, they have to include pain in their GI.
This is honestly worse than what happened with the Tuskegee Airmen. If they do that,
the Tuskegee Cheeto experiment.
Yeah. I do have a fast food idea. I'm curious what you guys would think about it. And don't tweet me because everyone's going to tweet me some bullshit. Version. They have bullshit versions of it, but I want to see a real version. The breakfast pizza. That's what I would like to see. Imagine a pizza, crust all made of maybe biscuit or something, and just fucking all breakfast foods. Eggs, sausage.
Some cheese, some cheddar cheese. Yeah,
this leads
like
to my response to the sir who asked the question. I want a 24-hour fast food, breakfast food only restaurant called Breck Forever, And it's just different breakfast things you can get through a drive-thru.
Or maybe you could have a good name, but I like the idea.
No,
like
Breck Forever.
A 24-hour breakfast place. You should have a catchy name, like, I don't know, Denny's.
No, there's no drive-thru there. And it's too expensive.
Breck Slow and Steady wins the food.
All right, it's called Brexit.
Yeah. Oh, Brexit would be perfect. Yeah.
You know what I used to make when I was a kid?
I'm changing it.
And I think there's a real opportunity because, like, we've gotten to the phase where we're getting, like, nostalgic about, like, obscure sodas. Is I used to make a Ruby Red Squirt milkshake. That sounds bad. It was fucking great.
Ruby okay. Red
Me and my dad invented
milkshake.
This shit.
Sounds like something I'd enjoy.
Fucking good.
I get it. Because, like, you know how, like, an orange creamsicle sort of works?
That, but I feel
it's going to work in the same way,
I feel
though.
Like a Ruby Squirt is a little too tart.
It
grapefruit
is tart.
Grapefruit is good.
No, it's going to cut that. The cream from the fat from the cream is going to cut that tartness nicely.
Oh, it does, my friend. And I'm glad that at least one person on this podcast has some fucking vision.
I would try.
I had vision, and you denied my vision. You blinded me. I was on your side.
I figured out that if you say you want fat to cut something, people, that's how you know somebody watches the Food Network, if they use that sentence. Like, it's a little acidic for me. You really want to cut that.
Chopped marathon.
Yeah, okay. Someone saw an Alton Brown episode and they think they know fucking taste science.
He's a wide receiver for the Steelers.
No, he's not. Shut up.
should we bang some voicemails?
Do you have any questions from your neck
of
the
woods? I
have
a bunch, but Ramsey's got a heart out and I want to get to some of the voicemails in a minute.
Yeah,
so some of the questions we have aren't 200th episode specific.
No, I mean, none of them really were.
No, but I mean, a lot of them aren't Ramsey specific, so I just want to see if we have any Rams specific stuff.
We do have a Rams specific voicemail right out of the gate. Let's take a listen to
this. I was just wondering how many iTunes views for Ramsey to hit a vape out of Tom's ass. Love you guys.
How many iTunes reviews for you to hit a vape out of Tom's ass?
That's going to take a lot of iTunes reviews and a little Patreon money, fellas.
What is hit a vape out of his ass?
I like to think it's one of those cylindrical ones, and you put it almost all the way in, and when he's got to take a hit, he pushes it so the button gets pressed by his asshole. Tensile strength.
Yeah, I was thinking maybe you press Tom's nose and it pushes the muscles.
See, here's what I was thinking, is that the end where the smoke comes out is in Tom's ass, and then the other end's sticking out, so you just sort of hit it. But then the smoke just comes out of his asshole.
He's got to, like, shotgun it.
Yeah.
You know,
I love that nobody asked if Tom was into this
here's
idea.
The thing. The old me would have gone, that's never going to happen. The new me dissociates. And so I don't. I have no present. My body is just a piece of thing.
Do we want to say 600 iTunes reviews and $50 for Ramsey?
Yeah, give me $50, dude.
No, I need money, too.
All right, $50 for you, too.
All right, sure.
All right. Let's hear this one.
All right, I've got a question I need Keith's expertise for. I'm wondering what would happen. This is Rebecca from the Discord, by the way. What would happen if someone were to, say, hypothetically inject a cow with something in the ballpark of 2 grams of methamphetamine, crystal? If you were able to inject the cow with that much meth, all at once, what do you think would happen? Would it die? Would it rampage? Would it just have a rockin' time? Let me know. Fuck everything. God is dead.
Here, I'll tell you what right now. You get that milk, you give it to Ramsey, he has his new energy drink.
Close.
Yeah. Made from the milk of a meth cow.
We use the Jesse Reed method.
Yeah, I mean, I don't have to tell you, because whatever was going to happen to that cow has already happened to that cow.
Absolutely.
By this point, that cow is either dead or running right now.
Yeah, fuck, okay.
Yeah, the cow built its own barn.
Now, I wonder, did they ask you this question, and pardon my French here, because you're overweight or because of your experience with meth in your family?
I got to figure a little bit of column A, a little bit of column math.
Yeah.
I thought it was a...
Either way, rude.
I love that you were polite about it.
It was an abstract mom joke, maybe?
I don't know. Well, regardless... Cool.
I like
there's some assembly required on whatever that thought was.
Yeah. I like you assembled the jokes.
I like what Tom did. Yeah, that was good.
All right, this one's a short one.
Tom Goss's ass.
Just said Tom Goss's ass.
Oh, I bet. I think that's the vape guy.
A lot of Tom Goss ass talk on this pod.
Yeah.
Okay.
Hey, Mean Boys. This is Plops Magoo. I just wanted to say thanks for doing the show and for coming to Nashville earlier this year.
You're welcome.
You guys are awesome. You crack me up every week at my crusty-ass factory job.
Thank you, buddy.
Also, Tom, leaving the Tribe podcast, keep doing your shit, man. I just listened to the episode with Robin, and it's good shit. Anyway, I've got a question for you guys. If you ordered Uber today and a self-driving car showed up.
Oh, we did this already.
Would you get inside of it?
Okay. Yeah.
Thanks.
I don't remember. Refer back to an earlier.
Yeah. I'll say that. Look, let me answer this question. My girlfriend is always freaked out about this. She's always like, oh, I don't know if I'd get into it.
She's like, Ramsey, you don't know how to do this. Stop trying to modify my Prius. I have to go to work.
She's like, I don't know if I would get into a self-driving car. And I said, all right, well, keep getting into a Lyft car then, where a driver's been on his 16th hour shift.
Yeah.
And he's got an Oxycontin addiction. Good for that. Yeah, that's a lot safer.
That is a pretty good point, if I'm being honest. That's an argument I don't hear a lot.
Yeah, Jesus Christ, you understand. Okay, never mind. I was going to say something that could incriminate me. Let's move on.
Usually it's just things that'll incriminate me.
All right, here's one. This is the 200th episode.
Boys, congratulations on your 200th episode. This is Alexis.
We know.
I just wanted to know, since it is kind of a milestone, what are some of the things that you had planned on doing that just never came to fruition?
Making a podcast.
Ideas
good.
That you had that you wish you could have done, but time or finances got in the way. I remember you guys talking about with the Patreon where you were considering getting cameras, things like that, and then it never kind of panned out. So is there anything that you really wish you could have done and just never managed to get the time or finances together to do? And looking back, is there anything that you might have changed here or there? All right, that's all. Congratulations again, guys. Fuck everything. God is dead.
I will say my biggest sort of – I wanted to do this for the 200th episode, and I will still do it at some point, I hope, is I just want to do an episode that is a full-throttle musical.
Oh,
just like
yeah.
Every word of it is scripted. Like, I want to write a Broadway musical that is just an episode of Mean Boys. That's the thing I've always wanted to do.
Like Scrubs did?
Yeah, kind of.
Yeah, okay.
Wait, Scrubs did it?
Things we wanted Scrubs. To do that we didn't get around to. I mean, like some boring technical stuff, but I guess I'm trying to think of any big... I don't know. We pretty much left it all in the field, as far as I can remember.
And the stuff I kind of like, you know, that we haven't done is stuff I still want, like video sketch stuff I want to do at some point, like, you know...
Yeah, I'm trying to think for like podcast specific because most of like what you said, it's mostly technical stuff and like distribution stuff like that.
Yeah, anything we would have done differently? I'll start. We wouldn't have done that bad audio network thing.
Yeah, that was a bad idea.
Dude.
That was great. It was like, we know how we'll rebuild the phoenix of this podcast. We'll isolate half of our listeners and make them never come back.
Yeah.
Did people do that? A lot of people drop off.
We lost literally half of our audience.
Yeah.
I got it back for you guys.
I would probably have never had the idea to do Snark Week.
Snark Week rocks, man. This last one wasn't even that bad.
Not even that. It's just it sucks to do it. It just made me miserable.
I genuinely
going crazy both times.
Yeah, no, you were having a rough go.
Yeah,
I like doing Snark Week.
I hate it. So yeah, I guess I would not do that.
I wouldn't have dated that one girl.
I would also have not dated that one girl.
Yeah,
nor would I have dated her again.
I would have not dated those three girls.
Would have not dated Jessica.
I'm trying to think of podcast specifically.
From a non-podcast point of view, like a professional point of view, there's something I've always wanted to do, a one-man show on the Palestinian-Israeli conflict from the perspective of a white supremacist. What do you
It's called One Hate Solution.
I just think it's so funny, man. Yeah.
Who do I choose? The Browns or the Jews?
Thanks.
We got
one. Whoever wins, I'm going to lose.
This
Tell
one,
me I can't write a musical episode.
Damn right, dude. Better than Seth MacFarlane himself.
Yeah. Low bar. You're better than that guy who's pretty bad at what he does.
And by that, I mean I also think you're gay.
Yeah.
Connor, you're making a pretty interesting face right now.
I'm just looking at the predictive text of this voicemail, and it seems like a lot. But, this is 3 minutes. This will probably close us out for the week.
This is John from Madison. Met you a couple years ago, a year ago in Milwaukee.
Oh, hell yeah.
I was a super hippie-looking dude that Keith roasted for having the super neon sweatshirt.
I remember you.
I just wanted to say, I just started listening to you guys after, 9 months of just not listening to podcasts, really. Although I did contribute to your Patreon, 6 of those months before I got to the point where I was like, sorry, boys, daddy's got to keep the power on. But I wanted to say,
thank you.
You know, you guys, I've been listening to your episodes recently. I just listened to the Steve Renazzisi episode where you talked about suicide and all that. I'd say you guys are doing some fucking amazing stuff for your fans. Like, seriously. I have had a really shitty life when I met you guys. I was kind of starting my come up back on fixing my life. It was right around the time that I got diagnosed with PTSD, and which made a whole bunch more of my life make sense. But, you know, I went from being some fucking stupid drug-dealing loser who had nothing going for him in his life and who hated his life. I tried killing myself a couple of times. I was thinking about it in the week before I saw you guys. You know, that was like a bright moment that kind of helped cheer me up. And now I've got a good job. I've got fucking health insurance for the first time. I'm going to therapy, dealing with my shit. Like, I don't wake up every day hating my life. I'm about to go to school to be an EMT. Like, I don't know. I wanted to say that it was really funny listening to one of your most recent episodes and hearing the ad for Starbucks before it. The real fucking turnaround from listening to Keith try to get us to go to some, like, Korean gambling website 2 years ago. So, you guys are on the come up, and, you know, your fans are too, and you guys are part of that, and I just want to say thank you from all of us. And to the fans that are going through their own shit, you're not alone. We all deal with it, and it sucks. Life sucks, but we're all in it together. So, yeah. Sorry, it's so fucking sappy and all that shit. Love you guys. Fuck everything. God is dead.
Wow. Thank you, man. That really means a lot, dude.
Yeah, we were all fighting it, but we were all ultimately like, I could feel it in the room of all of us being like, should we say something funny? Should we make, and then we were all just kind of like, this is just nice. Yeah. Go ahead and be
I actually wasn't thinking about it.
Were you not thinking it? Maybe no. It was just only
I've gone
me.
Soft.
No, I was there too.
Were you there too?
Yeah.
There was that part of me. I just always had that instinct of like, God, oh God, should I say it? And then I'm like, you know what? This guy's being earnest.
I got no real quick. I'm just, I'm happy to hear that.
Yeah, I talked to homie a little bit on the... online, I think.
I mean, I talked to him in person at that show. I remember him. He's a real nice guy, and I'm really happy to hear that he's doing better. It's nice to hear that someone who listens to the show is doing better and isn't dead. That's always refreshing.
That's a nice change of pace.
Yeah,
I'm really glad to hear you putting some work into yourself and that you're seeing some results. And
yeah,
feeling
I'm
more
very
positive,
happy to
man.
Hear that.
I mean, you were wearing a rainbow like Grateful Dead sweatshirt, so there was really nowhere to go but up. At that
Yeah,
no, but we're stoked, man. Thank you for all the kind words.
Yeah, but really
and thank
appreciate
you for offering
it, man.
Me those drugs you used to sell.
Yeah, well, what did he sell? I want to know.
I'll tell you off air. I don't know if he wants. I don't know if he wants evidence.
Well,
now he's trying to
voice,
like have
he's
a
got prices
job.
And a suit.
Let me tell you his phone number and see if that helps him narrow it down. He's got his address. Is listed 1-800 in his contact.
Drugs for Rams.
This happens to every podcast I'm a guest on. Some drug dealer inevitably calls in.
I will say on our 200th episode, just before we go, that that I don't think I tell you guys enough how much you mean to me, and the fact that what we do here means something to you. And is helpful to you in these times in your lives is by far the best thing that I've ever done with my time on Earth, and it means more to anything that means more than anything I've ever done to me, and I appreciate it so much, and the feeling of meaning that comes along with that is confusing to me. It's a little mind blowing and hard to process, but it is not. Absent from my thoughts, it is there most every day. So I just want to thank you guys and just let you know again that the fact that I'm, you know, in some degree with you guys able to do for you what, you know, this shit was for me in times in my life is the coolest thing in the world to me, and I've not stopped appreciating that, even though I am not funny on the podcast anymore. And have stopped trying.
I echo all of everything you just
said.
Yeah,
same. We all think Connor's not funny anymore on the podcast.
No, this is, it would be, we're getting into some real, like, some, some feel good strewed right now, and I just, you know, but
don't make me regret all of this.
No, I seriously though, this is it's fucking bizarre to think that we're at 200. We did. I don't know what else I've done 200 times.
That's what push-ups. I was going to say.
Tacos. Push-ups. If your stories are to believe.
Well, I did. That was, what was it?
I don't know. How many times did you go to the mental hospital? Because it's got to be close.
It's got
days? Definitely.
The mental hospital is better when Joe worked there. All right, that's our 200th episode. We got my favorite guest of all time. I'll just go ahead and say it. Ramsey Badawi, the big-ass Ram dog.
Well, let me say
something
nice.
At RamsBad on Twitter.
You guys are great. Love the podcast. Love the fans. Together we'll make the white race great again.
Oh, yeah.
Thanks for saying that right after I got a TV writing job. So I know you're a good friend. You don't want me to forget my roots, living in poverty.
Jesus Christ. It's so weird that the both of you, I now have to constantly be like, I guess I got to be careful what I invite them to do with me.
Ramsey, you can
invite me. Oh, it's not in my Twitter bio anymore. I'm playing it safe.
My man, you know, I know.
I've been waiting for an invite to anything since I met you.
Tom, we'll figure it out. We'll get something going. We don't have enough adventures with just you and I.
Yeah.
Ramsey, you've never gotten an invite from Ramsey? It's great. You show up somewhere, and then he decides last minute he's not doing it. And then you have to drive back to your house from Santa Monica. It's great. It's awesome, this
Wait,
guy.
When did that happen?
I'm just kidding.
I was going to say, that really hurt my feelings.
I'm sorry. I was making fun of you.
It's fine. I love all of you guys. I love the Mean Boys fans. Thank you for your continued support. You guys are constant. It's like a, you know what it's like? It's like a giant Debtors Anonymous meeting.
It is nice to fucking, it's just weird that sometimes I tweet something and people just say stuff to me and I'm like, oh wow, that's fucking, I never thought that would be a thing.
Yeah, that's nice. Pretty cool.
Yeah, pretty weird that anyone listens to us.
Yeah. But keep doing it, I guess. We'll see you next week.
Yeah, see you next week.
Everybody. Fuck everybody.